everyone. My name is Hua, and today we're gonna get to reading this book. And I want to say to you this sentence. Merry Christmas. It's nearly Christmas now. It is 22nd now. It only need to get to, Friday and Saturday. It's gonna be Christmas, and you know, let's come on and read this book together. I mean, I'm gonna read it to you because you doesn't got it yet, I think. Ignore the dog bark, okay? Just listen to me. I will start to going it bigger. Ginger and pickles. Once upon a time, there was a village shop. The name over the window was Ginger and Pickles. It was a little small shop, just the right size for dolls. Lucinda and Jane Doll Cook always bought their groceries at Ginger and Pickles. Oh, two little toys again. The counter inside was the convenience hide for rabbits. Ginger and Pickles sold red spotty pocket handkerchiefs at a penny tree for things. They also sold sugar and snarf and galoshes. In fact, although it was such a small shop, it sold nearly everything, except a few things that you want in a hurry, like bootlaces, hairpins, and mutton chops. Mutton chops? Here, it's kind of weird. Ginger and Pickles were the people who kept the shop. Ginger was a yellow tomcat, and Pickles was a terrier, or like a dog. The rabbits were always a little bit afraid of Pickles. The shop was also patronized by mice. Only the mice were rather afraid of Ginger. Ginger Ashwali requests Pickles to serve them because he said it made his mouth water. "I cannot bear," said he, "to see them going out at the door carrying their little parcels." "I have a safe feeling about rats," replied Pickles. "But it would never do to eat our customers. They would leave us and go to Tabitha Twitchit's. On the contrary, they would go nowhere," replied Ginger gloomily. Tabitha Twitchit kept the only other shop in the village. She did not give credit. Ginger and Pickles gave unlimited credit. Now the meaning of credit is this: when a customer buy a bar of soap, instead of a customer pulling out a purse and paying for it, she says she will pay another time. And Pickles make a low bow and says, "With pleasure, madame," and it is written down in a book. The customers come again and again and buy quantities in spite of being afraid of Ginger Pickles. But there is no money, what is called a till. The customers came in crowds every day and bought quantities, especially the toffee customers. But there was always no money. They never paid as much as the pennyworth or pepper of peppermints. But the sales were enormous, 10 times larger as Tabitha Twitchit's. As there was always no money, Ginger and Pickle were obliged to eat their own goods. Pickles ate biscuit and Ginger ate a dried haddock. What's a haddock? They ate them by candlelight after the shop was closed. When it came to Jan, there was still no money, and Pickle was unable to buy dog license. It is very unpleasant, and I am afraid of the police, said Pickles. It is your own fault for being a terrier. I do not require a license, and neither does Cap, the collie dog. It is very uncomfortable. I am afraid I shall be summoned. I have tried in vain to get a license upon credit at the post office, said Pickles. The place is full of policemen. I met one as I was coming home. Let's send it to the bill again to Samuel Whiskers. Ginger, he owes 22 a night for bacon. I do not believe that he intends to pay at all, replied Ginger. And I feel sure that Anna Maria pocket things. Where are all the cream crackers? You have eaten them yourself, replied Ginger. Ginger and Pickles retired into back parlor. They did accounts. They added up sums and sums and sums. Samuel Whiskers has run up a bill as long as his tail. He has an ounce of 3/4 of snuff since October. What is 11 pounds of butter at? Something I didn't know. And a thick sealing wax of 4 matches. Send in all the bills again to everybody with compits, replied Ginger. After a time, they heard a noise at the shop. In the shop, as if something had been pushed in at the door. They come out of a black parlor. There was an envelope lying on the counter and a policeman writing a notebook. Pickles nearly had a fit. He barked and made little rushes. Bite him, Pickles! Bite him! Spluttered Ginger behind a sugar barrel. He only a German doll. The policeman went on writing in his notebook. Twice he put his pencil in his mouth, and once he dipped in the trellis. Treglo or something. Pickles barked till he has a horse, but still the policeman took no notice. He had bead eyes and his helmet was sealed on his digits. At length, on the last little rush, Pickles found that the shop was empty. The policeman had disappeared, but the envelope remained. Do you think that he has gone to fetch a real-life policeman? I am afraid it is a summons, said Pickles.
No,
replied Ginger, who had opened the envelope at the rates and taxes. This is the last straw, said Pickles. Let us close the shop. But they put up the shutters and left, but they have not removed from the neighborhood. In fact, some people wish we had gone further. Ginger is living in a warren. I do not know that occupation the purses. He looks stout and uncomfortable. Pickles is at the present gamekeeper. The closing of a shop caused great inconveniences. Tabitha Twitchit and Kimley raised the price of everything a half penny, and he continued to refuse to give credit. Of course, there are tradesmen part, a butcher, a fishman, and Timothy Baker. But a person cannot live on seed wings and sponge cake, and butter buns are not even when the sponge cake is as good as Timothy's. After a time, Mr. John Dormouse and his daughter began to sell peppermints and candles. They did not keep self-fitting sixes, and it take 5 miles to carry 1 7-inch candle.
Ooh!
Besides, the candles with a shell has very strangely in warm weather. And Miss Dormouse refused to take back at the end where it brought back with her with complaints. And when Mr. John Dormouse was complained to, he stayed in bed and would say nothing but very snug, which is not the way to carry on a retail business. So everybody was pleased when Sally Hennypenny sent out a print poster to say that she was going to the reopen shop. Henry's opening sale. Grand cooperative jumble. Penny prices. Come buy, come try, come buy. The poster is not most ticking. But there was a rush upon opening the day. The shop was crammed with customers, and there were crowds of mice upon biscuit canisters. Sally Hennypenny grew rather flustered when she tries count out change, and she insists being paid cash, but she is quite harmless, and she has laid in a remarkable assortment of board games. There is something to please everybody. The end. This book is reading quite good, but it got a lot of words that made me not know, so I do not understand this book really well. Well, happy Christmas and goodbye, everybody. See ya in the next video. Bye-bye, and do not forget to leave without a like and subscribe on this video. Bye-bye, and real.